Dilly, this is just another trial. Just another trick. Just to distract you from your real mission. You think you know, but you don't. Your mother is dead. You don't know anything. Dillian is dead.
Lighting the torch. not gonna help her.
Darkness. Do you think you can keep away from the
shite?
Send She has it.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? There are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
So.
torch is going out.
No, it's not. It's going to run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
She's too slow. It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again. Did I? I don't remember. I was only five. They told me she escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here? Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dewey. She knows the beast is there.
He's always watching you.
The beast is there. You're never safe from him.
You can feel him.
Be careful. She needs to find him.
She has to fight it.
I can feel it. Is it? It's an old torch on it.
Up. You're never gonna find it.
Are you even going the right way?
Quickly.
He was doing his best.
She never, ever listens.
Why didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbo was right.
Zimbo was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
She should have known. She should have known. Why doesn't she learn before she learns? She doesn't understand.
Now
the dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man will want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Deeper and deeper.
The beast knows. The beast knows exactly where she is.
She's falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
Plays into his hands.
The darkness is coming.
The lights run out. She'll die.
She can't.
She'll die.
She has to.
She can't.
She's going to go through anyway.
The light will run out. The lights run out.
The darkness will spread.
And she'll die. What's she doing?
She's lighting the torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking?
Thank you.
She can do it.
Sigurd kills the dragon. Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
What's she doing?
She's lighting the torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
We will find.